Hi everyone, it's Bianca here. Welcome to a new tutorial. In this tutorial, I'll show you how to make this awesome tote bag. I made this tote bag with yarn from Scheepjes, truly scrumptious. This is made with recycled plastic bottles. Yes, you hear it right, with recycled plastic bottles. How awesome is that? You need 4 balls of yarn to make this tote bag. I use several colors. It's up to you how many colors you want to use. There are 100 grams on 1 ball. In total, I use 400 grams to make this tote bag. The label states that you can use a 5mm crochet hook, but I use a crochet hook of 6mm, otherwise I find the stitches are too tight. But before we start, I would like to ask you to help me out by subscribing to my channel if you haven't already done so. Give a thumbs up, click on the notification bell so you don't miss any new tutorial, leave comments and share this video. We are going to start making squares, 13 in total. I start with the first color, make a magic circle on the hook. And we begin to make our first double crochet, that's a chain 3. It's 1, 2, and 3. Now you're in a magic circle, make 11 double crochets. That's 1, 2, three. My last double crochet, number 11. With your first chain 3, now you have here 12 double crochets, all in that same magic circle. Now pull on that short tail to close the magic ring. Cut the yarn. And now we open up that stitch. Pull your hook all the way up. And we make a invisible join in the beginning with a needle. We skip the first double crochet, that's the chain 3. We go to the next double crochet here on top under through that V stitch. The front to the back, pull through. You go back to the last double crochet, only in the back loop, and then you work also in the back loop of that chain 3 top in the third chain stitch and pull through. Make on the back a little knot and weave both tails in. Round 2 with a second color. And we make a slip knot on the hook and begin with a standing double crochet between 2 stitches, not on the top of that double crochet stitch, but between the 2 stitches. The yarn is on the hook, yarn over, then between the 2 double crochets, grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over, pull through 2, yarn over and pull through 2. A standing double crochet. Back in that same space, another double crochet. So we have here 2 double crochets between the 2 double crochets of the previous round. This is also the repeat. You work all the way around 12 times in total. Yarn over, skip the next double crochet, and then between the next 2 double crochets, work 2 double crochets in that same space. That's 1 and 2. Yarn over, skip the next double crochet between the next 2 stitches, make 2 double crochets between those 2 stitches. all the way around, 12 times in total. Cut the yarn on the end of this round and make an invisible join on the second double crochet. I start on the third color, make a slip knot on the hook and begin with a standing double crochet between two groups of two double crochets in that space here. Yarn over and we hook between the two groups of two double crochets, not on the top of that double crochet here, between the stitches. Grab your yarn. Yarn over, put for two, yarn over and put for two. In that same space, two more double crochets. We have here a group of three double crochets between the stitches. Now you skip the next two double crochets and then between the next two groups of two double crochets, work again, three double crochets between the two stitches. And this is the way how you work all the way around, 12 times in total. In the beginning, you work on the top of the second double crochet an invisible join. In round 4 we begin to create the square. The yarn is on the hook and then we start between the two groups of three double crochets between those stitches with a standing single crochet. The yarn is on the hook, go between the two groups, grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over and put for two. In that same space make two more single crochets. That's one and two. We have now three single crochets in that same space. Skip the next three double crochets and then between the next two groups make three single crochets. This is one straight side. We start on a corner, skip the next group of three double crochets and then between the next two groups make three double crochet in that space. It's one, two, and three. Then make a chain two. Three double crochets more in that same space. It's one, two, and three to complete the first corner. All these stitches repeat those three more times. So you start here on the first group of three single crochets between the next two groups of three double crochets. It's one, two, and three. Skip the next three double crochets, make three single crochets. Skip the next three double crochets and then in the next space make a corner. Three double crochets, chain two, three double crochets more in that same space. Repeat all these stitches two more times. Then close on top of the first standing single crochet with a slip stitch. I'm all the way around. We close with a slip stitch on top of the first standing single crochet. Don't cut the yarn. In the next round we use the same color. The final round, you start with a chain 3, counts for a double crochet. And this is the last double crochet of the first group here of the 3 double crochets. We work all the way around, and if we all the way around, then we have to make here in the last space here 2 more double crochets to complete the group of 3 double crochets here. So we skip over the next 3 single crochets, and then between the 2 groups of 3 single crochets here in that space, make a group of 3 doubles. It's 1, 3 double crochet, 2, and 3. Skip the next 3 single crochets, then between the 3 single crochets and the 3 double crochets in that space, make a new group of 3 double crochet. And then we have to make a corner in the chain 2 corner space. 3 double crochets in that chain 2 corner space. Chain 2, 3 double crochets back in that same chain 2 corner space to make your first corner complete. This is the way how you work all the way around. You skip now the next 3 double crochets, and then between the double crochets and the single crochets, make a new group of 3 doubles. Then a new group of 3 doubles between the next 2 groups of 3 singles. Then between the single crochet and the corner 3 double crochets, also a group of 3 double crochets, and then in the chain 2 corner space a new corner. 3 double crochet, chain 2, 3 double crochet, all the way around. And I'll show you how to work that last group of 3 double crochets here in the beginning, and then the square is complete. I'm all the way around. I made my last corner here. Now we skip the next 3 double crochets after that fourth corner, and then we have to make 2 more double crochets between the group of 3 double crochet and the group of the single crochets here for that chain 3 in that space. 2 double crochets, so we have another group of 3 double crochets with our first chain 3 here. You see, close with a invisible join on the top of the first double crochet of the group of 3. Make 13 squares in total. I lay my squares on the ground. I have not enough place on my table, and this is tip 10 how we make all the squares together. And if you see, you have here on the top of your bag 2 squares. Then the next row we have 3, then also 2 in the next row, and this is the center square, only 1. Then we have to place 2 squares, then 1 and 2. These 2 squares and these 2 squares are the top of the bag. This square here in the middle is the bottom of the bag. We work all the squares together with slip stitches, and the first 2 squares are these 2, and we make slip stitches on this way here. I'll show you. These are the 2 squares, and we make slip stitches from corner to corner. I made a slip knot on the hook, and now we place our working tail under the 2 squares. And then we can start. The yarn is on the hook, and now we begin here. For the first double crochet of the group of 3, in that chain stitch here in the corner, we made here two single crochets, and then in the single crochet for the first double crochet, and then we're going to work only in the back loop of that whole stitch. That's here in the middle of that stitch, go only in the back loop. Also this square here in that chain for the group of three double crochets, you work also only in the back loop of that whole stitch. Now you have three loops on the hook, yarn over and pull through all the loops on the hook. This is your first slip stitch. Now enter your hook in the next stitch here in the first double crochet, only in the back loop, and here under also in the first stitch of the three double crochets, also only in the back loop, yarn over and pull through three loops on the hook. This is the way how you work those slip stitches, only in the back loop of that whole stitch. So in the next stitch only in the back loop, in the next stitch only in the back loop, and make that slip stitch. Make those stitches not too tight, work very loosely. See, like this, all the way up across to the next corner. I have to make one more join stitch, and that's in the first chain after that last double crochet, only in the back loop, and also here under after that three double crochets in the first chain in the corner, only in the back loop. Make one chain and then cut the yarn. Two squares that we joined together is back on the ground, and now we have to make the next row complete. These three squares also here from corner to corner and from corner to corner. Then the next four squares, make join stitches like this, then in the next three, and then only one, but there we have not to make the join stitches. I done with the join stitches in this direction. Now we have to work the join stitches on this direction. Be sure that you follow the pattern like this. Here on the top we have two squares, that's the top of the bag, then three squares, two squares, the center square, only one, two squares, one and two squares, also the top of the bag. So the first squares that we join together is those two here and those three here, from corner to corner and from corner to corner. I join the squares together, the next row, that's the four. We work like this. We skip the first square and then we attach the next six squares. Then after that we join the three squares on the row of four squares at this way. Skip here the first square and then the next four squares, we work the join stitches like this, and then we work only the single square here in the middle of that three, from corner to corner. I made all my join stitches. This is what we have now. The pattern
1, 2 on the top, followed by 3 squares, then 2, 1, the center square, 2, 1, and 2. Now we flip over our work, and then we fold this part to that part. This is the back of my work, this is the center square, and we fold this center square together. So, we grab this part here, and we flip over. So this is the center square, you see? So this here is the top of the bag. And the center square is the bottom of the square. So here, that square here on the side, we fold it also together like this. We fold it to the inside. And then we have to make join stitches from here of the square of the bottom. Then here up, that's one side. We go to the inside, that's two. And then to the outside, that's three. We do this also on the other side. This square here, we fold that to the inside of the bag. And then we have to make join stitches here from the center square here in the corner to the corner here, then up and to the outside. So you work join stitches from here, 1, 2, and 3 sides. Also here, 1, 2, and 3 sides. So I complete all the join stitches, and this is what we have now. This is the top of the bag, and this is the center square. Now we have all these loose tails all over, some on the outside, some in the inside of the bag. Now we work all the tails in the inside of the bag, and we weave in the back of the stitches. And here, these little holes here, we have these tails. You can sew in that tail here, from this side to this side, and from this side to this side. So we close that little gap here in the middle. We do this also here in the bottom of the bag. We have 3 tails. And I zoom a little bit in so you can see what I mean. We have here 3 tails of the center square here. So you have here 3 tails. You cross over those tails from this side to this side, from this side to that side, and from this side to sew in that little gap here. So we have no gap more here in the center. I weave all the tails in on the back of the stitches, and you see all the little holes here between the squares are completely closing here. You see? We have to make handles, but first we start all the way around on the top of the bag here with single crochets. Same color as back on the hook, and we start here in the point of a chain 2 with a standing single crochet. Enter your hook in that chain 2, grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over, and pull for 2. Back in that same space, make another single crochet, so you have 2 single crochets in that same chain 2 corner space.
Now on top of every double crochet, we work one single crochet. The first single crochet we have to make here in the first double crochet after that chain two corner. In that whole stitch, only through that V on the top. Make in every stitch one single crochet. I made here from the first point single crochets on this straight side here, and now we have to jump over to the next square. How we do this? Here in the chain two corner space from the first square, you make in that chain two corner space also one single crochet. Now here you see the join stitches. You jump over the join stitch and then in that stitch here and in the next stitch also for the join stitches here, you work two single crochets together. So we jump over the join stitches here and then anywhere in a stitch, it doesn't matter where, you choose one little gap, you go in with your hook, you grab your yarn and pull up. Now you jump over the chain two here and then for the next join stitches of the next two squares, you work for the join stitches anywhere in a stitch, it doesn't matter which one, you choose one little hole, you go in with your hook, then grab your yarn and pull up. So you have here three loops on the hook and we work these three loops together. Dus yarn over and pull through three loops in one go. Then here of the next square, you have here also a chain two. In that chain two work one single crochet. And then you have to work in every top of the next double crochets here on the straight side all the way up to the next point single crochets. And your first single crochet is here the first double crochet after that chain two. So you work in every stitch one single crochet all the way up to the next point. With all my single crochets, I have to make one more single crochet here on the top of the last double crochet. And then you have here the chain two space. And then we start all over again. At the same way that we did here in the first point, with two single crochets. So in that chain two space, two single crochets. And then you work all the way down. On top of every double crochet, one single crochet. And then you work here to jump over to the next two, to the next square. You work one single crochet here in the chain two space. Then you jump over the join stitches. Then you work here and for the next join stitches, two single crochets together. You work in the next chain two space of the next corner one single crochet and then on top of every stitch one single crochet till you get here on the top of the next point here and you work then two single crochets in that same chain two space. You work like this all the way around. Then we close here on top of the first standing single crochet a slip stitch. The last two stitches, then I'm all the way around, close with a slip stitch on top of the first standing single crochet. Don't cut the yarn, in the next round we use the same color. We're going to start to make the handles of the bag, and you can make the handles so big and long as you want. I think that I make chain stitches of 60 or 70, and then I see how it looks like. But first I start with a chain 60. So we work chain stitches, one, and work those stitches very loose. 2 and 3 and 4 5 6. I work here my 60 chain stitches, and I find my handle big enough. So be careful that you do not twist your chain stitches, and then you work here on the top of the second single crochet in that point here. You work 2 single crochets in that same stitch. You work a slip stitch. So go in with your hook on the top of that single crochet, yarn over, pull through, and pull through. After we attach the handle, we work in that same stitch where you make that slip stitch. 1 single crochet. So you go back into that same stitch, work 1 single crochet in that stitch. And now on top of every stitch, work again 1 single crochet. So we get to the point here to jump over to the next square. I work my single crochets, and now we have to jump over to the next square. And this stitch here in the middle, that's the point where we make the 2 single crochets together. We skip that stitch. Now the stitch for that stitch and after that stitch, these 2 stitches we work at the same way together with 2 single crochets together, and we skip here that center stitch. So you work in the stitch for the stitch that we work 2 single crochets together in the previous round. You go in with the hook, grab your yarn, pull up, then you skip that middle stitch here, and then that stitch after. You go in with your hook and grab your yarn, 3 loops on the hook, yarn over, and pull through 3 loops in 1 go. And then you work also on top of every stitch 1 single crochet. Work all the stitches to the next point. I made all my single crochets on this side, and now here in the next point we have here of the previous round make 2 single crochets in that same chain 2 point space. Now here on the top of the first single crochet of the 2 you work also 1 single crochet. And now we have to create a second handle. I create here for my bag 60 chain stitches. So I work again 60 chain stitches, and I touch with a slip stitch on top of the second single crochet here in the next point. In the next point we work 2 single crochets in that same space. So on the top of the second single crochet you attach that handle with a slip stitch. I have here now 2 handles, and then you start all over again at the same way that you did after that first handle. So you work in that same stitch here, back in that same stitch with a single crochet, work on top of every stitch 1 single crochet. And then here, to skip over to the next square, you skip that center stitch, that 2 single crochet together. You skip that stitch, and then the stitch 4, and after that stitch, you work 2 single crochets together. Then on top of every stitch, work 1 single crochet. And then we reach here that handle. I work my last single crochet here on top of the first square, and then here In every chain stitch, for me it's that 60 chain stitches, we work in every stitch one single crochet. You go in the middle of that stitch and make one single crochet, and that we do that on every stitch. So you work in every chain stitch in the middle of the stitch one single crochet. That's for me 60 stitches. I'm done to work in every chain stitch one single crochet. Now we have to work across the next square on top of every stitch also one single crochet. I work my stitches across the first square here, then we have to jump over to the next square. Now you see here the two center stitches. In these two center stitches we work two single crochets together. We do not skip a stitch like the previous round. So we jump into the next stitch and grab your yarn and jump over to the next stitch, grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over and pull for three. And now we have to work on top of every stitch of the next square also one single crochet. And this is the way how you work all the way around. Work all across this next square also single crochets, and then you will have to work in every chain stitch. For me it's that in chain 60, on top of every chain stitch one single crochet. Work like this all the way around and we close again with a slip stitch. I'm all the way around and now we have to work on top of the first single crochet of the handle a slip stitch. Now we start all over again. We make a chain. Back in that same stitch make one single crochet, and now on top of every stitch all the way around you work one single crochet. And if you reach the point here where we have to jump over to the next square, you work the two center stitches together with two single crochets together. Work like this all the way around, then on top of the first single crochet you have to work one slip stitch on the end of this second round of the handles, and then you have to work one more round at the same way. So you work three rounds on top of the handles. So I work all my stitches, make a slip stitch in the beginning and work the tails in. Now we have this. Now we have to work one more round in the inside of the handles. So you start here in the middle of the square with a standing single crochet. Then you work in every stitch one single crochet. In this point here you work two single crochets together to attach the to skip over to the next square, make single crochets on this side here. Then we get here to the point from the square to the handle. You work also at the same way that we did here, two single crochets together. Then you work on the inside of the handle all the way across to the next point here, single crochets. Then in this point here, from the handle to the square, you work two single crochets together. Work single crochets. And then on the top of the first standing single crochet, you close with a slip stitch, cut the yarn, weave the tails in, and then the back is complete. I make all my stitches, weave the tails in, and I finish my tote bag. Thank you. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. Click on the notification bell so you don't miss any new tutorial from me. Thank you for watching and I hope to see you next time. Bye!